Shah, Barakata Yahweh, Barakata Yahweh, Barakata Yahweh Shah.
After this, a delicacy savored in Zanzibar, Tanzania, turns deadly. 9 lives lost, 78 individuals hospitalized, all linked to one common denominator, sea turtle meat. Among the deceased are 8 children and a mother, their lives abruptly cut short. The cause? Chelonotoxism. That's right, a type of food poisoning triggered by sea turtle consumption. With no known antidote, the severity of the cases can escalate quickly, even leading to death. This isn't an isolated incident, it's happened before. As we speak, Zanzibar authorities urge residents and visitors alike to exercise caution, rethinking that next bite of sea turtle meat.
Shalom. All praises, glory, and honors due unto Yahweh, Bashum, Yahushai, Bashum, Aruchak, Wadash. Double honors to the elder apostles and bishops of the great millstone that rule well. Peace, blessings, and salutations unto those 4 elect tabernacle of David scattered abroad throughout the earth. Now, question to you Christians out there, you know, because according to most Christians, you know, you could pretty much eat whatever you want to eat because, the Lord died on the cross so that you don't have to keep the law. And thus, you're not held to the dietary law because that's under the old covenant. That's done away in the old covenant. So my question to y'all would be, all these individuals who are hospitalized, or even those children that died as a result of eating these amphibians, would it have made a difference if they prayed over it? You know, would it not have been the same outcome if they would have actually prayed over those sea turtles? You know, because our people have been, you know, led astray, you know, hearkening unto these lies taught by the Christian church that you can eat anything you want as long as you pray over it. And we know there's a set of things on the earth that the Lord told us to abstain from. That's, you know, clearly prohibited and is not for human consumption because it's unclean. All right. And, you know, the Lord gave those boundaries and those standards to the children of Israel because they're a holy people. Now, these might have been jakes because you got Israelites on that side of the world. I believe this island where this happened, that it was east of Tanzania, all right, East Africa. And there's Jake over there in Tanzania. All right. And maybe that explained why, you know, they immediately got judged, you know, eating that crap, because we're not supposed to be eating that. Even Job said, who can make a clean thing out of an unclean thing? Not one. And the Lord told us from the beginning, you know, what was unclean to us. All right. There's the reason why we have these laws in place. Now, the Lord didn't set these laws up just, you know, for it to be grievous to us. No, the Lord, he knew exactly what he was doing. All right. So judgment came down on these people that thought it was cool to eat that stuff. Now, we're not to be eating, you know, creeping things that, you know, creep upon the earth. All right, matter of fact, when we go into the dietary law, it gets specific on the types of meats that you can eat and what you can't eat. Let's go to Leviticus 11. And that's why when the kingdom of heaven is established, when we have the new heavens and the new earth, it's going to be a new righteous standard, a new righteous government that's going to enforce the Most High's righteousness and his instructions upon the earth. Because these people are living without the way of the Most High, and that's why, you know, they choose the flesh very quickly because it's pleasing to them, and the end result is always death, disease, sickness. The world has to be taught all over again. That's why there's going to be a great reset when the Lord comes back and you know, take these heathens down. All right. The Lord's going to set up over the earth one who is profitable, because right now, the way things are moving right now, everything is out of course. Therefore, the people walk on in darkness and total ignorance. All right. So this is Leviticus 11 and 1. It says, "And the Lord spake unto Moses and to Aaron, saying unto them, speak unto the children of Israel, saying, these are the beasts which you shall eat among the beasts that are on the earth. Whatsoever part of the hoof and is cloven footed and cheweth the cud," you know, it eats the grass, the greenery. All right, basically a herbivore among the beasts, that shall you eat. Nevertheless, these shall you not eat of them which chew the cud, or of them that divide the hoof, as the camel, because he cheweth the cud, but divideth not the hoof, he is unclean unto you. So we're not supposed to eat camel. And you got them damn towel heads, them Arabs, the Ishmaelites, you know, they known for them selling that camel meat. And they sell it to Jake right in their neighborhood. And we ain't supposed to eat that. That's not, according to their law, that's not halal. That's haram. That's not halal. It's not kosher. It's not clean. So we're not supposed to eat that shit. It says, "In the coney, because he cheweth the cud, but divideth not the hoof, he is unclean to you. And the har, because he cheweth the cud, but divideth not the hoof, he is unclean unto you. And the swine," and it's the, you know, this animal right here, man, the pig, you know, that's the most delicable animal to Jake. They'll eat literally any part of the pig. They'll eat it on some crackers. They'll eat it, you know, with some rice. You know, they'll eat pork on anything. "And the swine, though he divideth the hoof and be cloven footed, yet he cheweth not the cud, he is unclean to you." All right. And he's super toxic. All right. Doesn't sweat. All right. It consumes literally everything in his path. If it's dead, it'll eat it. So this is one of the most unclean animals that you can possibly eat. All right. But our people, you know, it's a delicacy to them. They'll tell you, no, you have to cook it right. And, you know, Jake, they're not going to be reproved. They're not going to put that swine down. And it's very easy to do. There's all type of alternatives. You know, if you eat pepperoni, if you eat bacon, you got beef and you got turkey alternatives. But Jake, like, no, I want the swine, though. They want it for the flavor. They'll flavor their greens with it. I wonder why our people are the most sickly. Why are they dying at alarming rates, you know, by way of these illnesses? Because they don't take care of their body, man. The Lord said, if you defile the temple, which you are, he will destroy it. You know, so our people, they do what the hell they want to do. And that's why I don't feel anything for them when they piling up in them hospital rooms. They do it to themselves because they don't care about their diets. And it says, "Of their flesh shall you not eat, and their carcass shall you not touch. They are unclean to you. These shall ye eat of all that are in the waters, whatsoever have fins and scales in the waters, in the seas and in the rivers, them shall you eat. And all that have not fins and scales in the seas and in the rivers, of all that move in the waters, and of any living thing which is in the waters, they shall be an abomination unto you." That's your squid, that's your octopus, that's your jellyfish. All right, I remember a few years back, you had a vocab and, you know, they little crew, you know, this was after they tried to roll up on the apostles when they had the back and forth with the elder apostles in New York. and went into some restaurant, and they was literally eating some damn jellyfish. No, they put it on camera. They thought it was funny. Totally unclean, and it's unholy. What does it mean to be holy? It means to be set apart, separate, and holy, clean, sanctified. And when you indulge in that behavior and eating like that, eating like a damn heathen, you're not being holy at all. All right, it says, and all that have not fins and scales in the seas. So that's all your shellfish, you know, your clams, your oysters, your crabs, your shrimps. You ain't supposed to eat none of that. And our people, they love. You can't tell them they can't, you know, eat, you know, their shrimp. They'll go to Bubblegum Shrimp. They'll go to Joe's Crab Shack. They'll hit up Red Lobster. You know, all these different places that serve these abominations. It's mainly our people you'll see eating that. Or you can even go to an all-you-can-eat buffet and let it be on a night where they're serving crab legs. That line is is a long line. All right, let me just put it like that. Okay? Everybody got their tray and their plate out. And standing in that line, and you got all these other options. You know, the salad bar is just wide open. Nobody's at the salad bar. Everybody's lined up for the crab legs. And that's the current disorder of this current world. Because it's under a lawless ruler. Esau, he's a lawless man. He's the man of sin. He gives you license to sin. And these heathens, they're in need of rulers. They need somebody to rule over them. Because they helping Esau tear up the earth. A lot of species are endangered because they want to eat everything. Like them sea turtles that they're eating over there, those are endangered sea turtles. Why are they disappearing? Because they're catching them and eating them. And no wonder why the Lord got these people dropping dead, because this incident happened before, like a few years ago, when you had seven people. They got sick and poisoned after eating those same sea turtles. Those are not for human consumption, man. Everything has its purpose, according to the that their natural habitat. Okay, like literally everything has its purpose. It says, they shall be even an abomination unto you, and you shall not eat of their flesh, which you shall have their carcasses in abomination. Whatsoever have no fins nor scales in the waters, that shall be an abomination unto you. And then they're gonna list all the unclean fowls. Let me jump down. Leviticus 11 and 27, it says, and whatsoever goeth upon his paws among all manner of beasts that go on all four, those are unclean unto you. Whoso toucheth their carcass shall be unclean until the evening. Okay? Yeah, and that's, you know, even the reptiles. Jake like to eat reptile. They'll eat alligator. They'll eat snakes. You know, lizards. They'll eat all that stuff. We ain't supposed to eat that. You're not supposed to eat possum, rabbit. But you go down south here in Babylon, anything that they can find, if they can, you know, put it in a pot with some tomatoes and potatoes and onions and garlic and all that, they'll put it in there. They'll drop it right on up in there, man. They'll drop some toad, some gator meat, all type of stuff. Or if you can fry it, you know, they'll put it in some batter and fry it up, and they'll eat that and throw a little hot sauce on it. Or people eat straight up like the heathen and wonder why they dropping off. All right, it says, verse 28, it says, "And he that beareth the carcass of them shall wash his clothes and be unclean unto the evening. They are unclean unto you. These also shall be unclean unto you among the creeping things that creep upon the earth, the weasel and the mouse." You know, some people that be eating mice, rats, you ain't supposed to eat that. And matter of fact, it's even in the prophecy in Isaiah the 66th chapter. You know, people in the midst of the groves eating swine's flesh, an abomination in the mouse shall be consumed together. So anybody that's eating like that, when the Lord comes back, you ain't going to make it. The abominable cannot enter into the kingdom. All right, that's in Revelation, the 21st chapter, the abominable. All right, Revelation 21 and 8. It says, "And the tortoise after his kind," and that's what? A turtle. Typically a herbivorous, one that lives on land. So you ain't supposed to eat no damn turtle. Okay? Or a tortoise. Now these are turtles that live on land. You ain't even supposed to eat the ones that go in the sea, that dwell in the sea, man, a sea turtle. That's why those people got poison in good form. Eight of them happened to be children, and the mom ended up dropping dead. All got poisoned. People need to learn how to leave shit alone, man. Let nature be what it is. The Lord created an order, man. Anytime you try to, tamper with the Lord's order, it always backfires. He says, "And the ferret and the chameleon and the lizard and the snail and the mole," you know, so basically, you know, all these different creatures you're not supposed to eat. Reptiles, amphibians, like frogs and salamanders. You ain't supposed to eat none of that stuff. It says, "These are unclean to you among all that creep. Whosoever doeth touch them when they be dead shall be unclean even until the evening." All right. So let me go from there and let's go to Leviticus 20. Leviticus 20 and 25, it says, "You shall therefore put difference between clean beast and unclean, and between unclean fowls and clean. And you shall not make your souls abominable by beast or by fowl or by any manner of living thing that creepeth on the ground, which I have separated from you as unclean. And you shall be holy unto me, for I, the Lord, am holy, and have severed you from other people, that you should be mine." So, you know, the heathens, they can do what the hell they want, but we're not supposed to do this, because we're a holy people. We're a special people unto the Lord. So, you know, we have certain standards, boundaries, you know, limitations, things that are prohibited. And, you know, that's how we're supposed to live. All right. You drop dead by eating sea turtle. And every morning do the Lord bring his judgment to light. And it fails not, that's for sure. Those people straight up got judged. The scripture saying in the epistle to Galatia, that he that soweth to his flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. You know? So those people got what they got. All right, let me get in the Apocrypha. You know, because this is more reason to be careful of your diet. And, you know, heathens, they're not taught that because they don't have the law. They live as brutes. You know, the heathen are literally like brutes. But our people, because they done been among the heathen for so long, they became like brutes too. So they eat like brutes. Sirach 37 and verse 27, it says, "My son, prove thy soul in thy life and see what is evil for it, and give not that unto it." And those people have to have been simple as hell, because if they didn't know that an incident like that happened before where people ate that same meat and dropped dead, they said seven people. You're going to go and 2 years later and you're going to do the same thing and eat that damn sea turtle, an endangered sea turtle. Those people were clearly not bright. All right. It says, "For all things are not profitable for all men, neither have every soul pleasure in everything." You know, not all things are meant to be consumed for your pleasure. Just because something might taste good doesn't mean it's good for you. That's what our people don't seem to understand. All right. It says, "Be not unsatiable in any dainty thing, nor too greedy upon meats." And they killed up a bunch of those turtles, probably. And, you know, roasted them, cooked them up. You know, took the damn shell off and, you know, diced them up, seasoned them. But you know they was grubbing down on those turtles. But they didn't think that, you know, there was going to be an end result. You know, I bet they felt terrible, man. Probably throwing up. You know, probably temperature was going up. Probably had high blood pressure. You know, heart start throbbing. You know, nausea. Body probably started ache. All kind of stuff. And that's what will happen to you if you're not careful. It says, "For excess of meats bringeth sickness, and surfeiting will turn into choler. By surfeiting have many perished, but he that taketh heed prolongeth his life." And yeah, they were surfeiting on them sea turtles and they perished. All right, so they got what they got. That was the just judgment of the Heavenly Father. 78 people hospitalized, 9 people dead. So I'm pretty sure the people there and even tourists will take heed now. Because the Lord has judgments happen to put fear on the people and to take away the evil. Because, you know, the law is not kept, you know, in this world. It tells you that in Habakkuk, the law is slack and never judgment never goes forth. So these people got to learn the hard way. But that's why ultimately, you know, when the Lord establishes his government, the tabernacle of David, you know, as the rulers on the earth, you know, because all the elect are going to be sitting on thrones and they're going to judge the world. This type of thing won't be a factor, all right, because the earth is going to be enforced under the law. All right, they're going to know, you know, what... the purpose for all things, why the Lord created the things that he created and what his intended purpose is. They're all going to learn, man, and they're going to know that, you know, like it tells you in Deuteronomy, the 4th chapter, you know, that they're going to basically come to the conclusion that, you know, we're a wise and understanding people, you know. Isaiah 2 and 1, it says, "The word that Isaiah, the son of Amos, saw concerning Judah and Jerusalem. And it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house shall be established in the top of the mountains, and shall be exalted above the hills, and all nations shall flow unto it. And many people shall go and say, come ye and let us go up to the mountain of the Lord, to the house of God, the God of Jacob, and he will teach us of his ways. We're going to teach them the dietary law. All right. Don't leave the turtles in the sea. Leave those clams, leave the shrimp, you know, all those scavengers, leave them in the bottom of the sea so that the seas can be filtered, so that the water can stay clean. The waters is unclean and toxic and poisonous because you're taking out the filtering system and eating it. So we're going to teach the nations all these things, man. Leave the pig alone. The pig is a garbage disposal for the earth. All right. And we will walk in his paths, for out of Zion shall go forth the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. All right. So all nations are going to learn. And, you know, the earth is going to be full of the knowledge of the Most High, because we're going to be priests. Okay. We're going to be a nation of kings and priests, and we're going to enforce them laws. All right. So, you know, those people, they got judged. Okay. They ain't supposed to be eating that stuff. Amphibians and reptiles. All right. We ain't supposed to eat none of that stuff. So, Here's the link to the article on it. Let me copy this now, and I'll put a link to it in the description. All right, so you know, Lord willing, you know, y'all will edify them and give all praise to y'all. Shalom.